Venture. It's an adventure brand. We go to abandoned buildings, underground tunnels, city rooftops, or hidden waterfalls to document our experience and tell stories. We've been across the country and even the world to explore the most magnificent and obscure places to travel to. And ultimately, we failed.
Yes, this is a story about a company of mine that I started in college that eventually crashed and burned.
Let's start at the beginning. I'm reaching the end of my freshman year at UCLA when my buddy Brendan has an idea for a travel blog.
Well, actually, wait. This isn't the real beginning. Let's go back a little further.
It's the start of senior year of high school. I've been exploring abandoned buildings for a couple years now. I was posting pictures of my adventures on Instagram when a dude slid into my DMs. And this was back when you couldn't just send a message on Instagram, you also had to send a photo. The message was from Brendan Delaney. Brendan went to high school with some people I knew. I never really met him, but I knew from Instagram that he did things similar to me. The message read, "Not trying to be weird or anything, but do you want to go on an adventure with me, Noah, and David Clark right now?" And I mean, who asked something like that? He seemed cool, so I had to see what this was all about. And so we met up and went on an adventure. And then another one.
About to go in. Hopefully we don't die.
And another one.
Ready.
And soon we were pretty good friends. Now, fast forward a year, I'm sitting in my dorm room at UCLA when I receive a text message from Brendan.
His idea made sense. We had a lot of stories worth telling, but there wasn't really a way to do it on Instagram. So we decided the best way to tell our stories would be through an adventure blog, and the best person to help us make this happen would be Jacob Phillips.
Jacob was the talent behind all our photos and videos. Give this guy a camera and a computer and he could do anything. So as freshman year ended, I flew home to San Jose for the summer and sat down with Brendan and Jake to plan our blog.
All right, what are we gonna name this thing?
How about The Outsiders?
That domain's taken.
What if we did The Farron Foxes?
Definitely not. What if we did Venture, but we spelled it with a CH?
I like Venture with a Y.
That domain's good.
In fall of 2016, we launched Venture. Our site had 6 articles, and we plan to add an article a week from our endless supply of backlogged adventures.
We did it!
Venture was received really well. We got praise from our friends and family, and even people we had never met. The next few months were spent creating articles, growing our Instagram, and occasionally making a recap montage of our adventures.
Things were going great, but eventually our articles became half-assed. Most of our articles were written hours before our deadline, and some were even posted late. And I think it was because we were just very overconfident in ourselves. We didn't realize how hard it was to grow a brand, and we kind of just expected things to blow up. On top of that, we're all busy with school and separated from by long distances, which made it really hard to grow Venture. But don't get me wrong, like, we still did a lot of work. Every single time we were home for break, all we did was go out and shoot to get more content.
About 6 months after we launched, Venture added a fourth member to our team, David Clark. David was another guy who went to high school with Brennan and Jake. David gave new life to our brand, and the following summer, we began a new chapter of Venture. Up until this point, we had made videos on Venture, but they never really told a story. In summer of 2017, we started trying to tell our stories through our videos, instead of just with articles. But as the summer came to a close, the same issues arose. We were once again separated and busy with school. The next year, we would go on the occasional trip and make half-hearted videos, but the truth is, we were all in very separate parts of our lives. I was about to finish up my third and final year at UCLA. Brendan was busy moving to Oregon and becoming a professional cliff jumper. Jake started his own real estate media company in San Jose, and David was flying around the country working for an award-winning film company.
The band had, for all intents and purposes, broken up. And there wasn't any ill will or anything. It was just that Venture wouldn't work when put on the back burner. And so kind of in an unspoken way, it fell apart.
Jump to September of 2018. I just got back from 2 months working for a floating festival company in Greece. I'm now a UCLA graduate living in Los Angeles. It's been months since Venture posted a video and almost a year since our last article.
I'm faced with a decision. Leverage my degree to find a stable job and join the working force, or continue to pursue my passion to become a YouTuber. Before I made my decision, I took a step back to evaluate things. Venture wasn't working, and so I asked myself why.
And honestly, it all boiled down to just one thing. We weren't posting consistently. So the answer to me became quite clear. I had to start my own channel.
And that leads us to today. This journey for me really didn't start out as wanting to become a YouTuber. It started as me just going on adventures with a few friends and wanting to tell our stories. I think I learned a lot from Venture, and I'm really glad with what it taught me. Most importantly, it taught me that nothing is just handed to you. You have to work for the results you want. So anyways, we all still make videos together. You're actually gonna be seeing a lot more from these guys in the future, and I cannot wait to show you guys the videos we've been working on.